Biryani, one of the royal delicacies and luxurious treats enjoyed on special occasion and during festivals. There are different variations of making biryani, which can be made either with chicken, mutton, lamb, prawn, or even with vegetables. The recipe that I am sharing in this video is a South Indian style prawn biryani made with siraga or jeera sambar rice. This is a one pot recipe and I am making this biryani using all-in-one electric cooker. So to begin, I have kept the electric cooker on saute mode. Heat around 2 tablespoons of ghee, which is also known as clarified butter, and 1 to 2 tablespoons of vegetable oil. Adding 2 to 3 cinnamon sticks, 1 star anise, 3 cardamom, 4 to 5 cloves and 2 to 3 bay leaves. Fry these spices for a while. Adding few cashews, which are totally optional. Next, I'm adding around 3 medium sized onions, which are long and thinly sliced. Saute the onions on low to medium heat. Next, adding around 1 tablespoon of crushed ginger and garlic and 3 to 4 green chilies, which are slit into half. So green chili you can adjust according to your spice level. Next, I'm adding around 3 to 4 medium sized tomatoes, which are cut into small cubes. Next, salt as per your taste. So I'm adding around 3 to 4 teaspoons of salt here. Here I've taken around 2 teaspoons of chili powder. So this is a normal Kashmiri chili powder. 2 teaspoons of coriander powder. And 1 teaspoon of cumin powder. Half teaspoon of pepper powder. Mix all the ingredients well. Here I've taken around 400 grams of prawns, which has been marinated with half teaspoon of turmeric and a teaspoon of salt for 20 to 30 minutes. Cook the prawns for a while. Adding around 1/3 cup of curd or yogurt. Mix it well. Next, I'm adding the rice. So here I've taken 2 cups of siraga sambar rice, which is rinsed and the water has been drained out well. Siraga or jeera sambar rice, largely grown in south part of India, especially in Tamil Nadu. It takes its name from siragam, which means cumin in Tamil, since it is small and ovular grain resembling like cumin seeds, and sambar means refers to season where this rice is grown from August to January. Adding this rice gives a good aroma and a great flavor to the biryani. If this rice is not available, definitely you can replace with basmati rice, but make sure to soak the basmati rice after rinsing for around 20 to 30 minutes before you add it into the pot. To cook siraga sambar rice, the ratio of rice to water is 1:1.5. That is, for 1 cup of siraga sambar rice, you need to add around 1.5 cups of water. So ideally, I need to use 3 cups of water here. for 2 cups of rice, but I have added only 2.5 cups of hot water because the tomatoes and the prawns will release some amount of water. So you can adjust around 2.5 to 2 3/4 cups of hot water. Next, I'm adding few chopped coriander and mint leaves, which gives a great flavor. I have cancelled the saute mode, closed the cooker with the lid and turning the vent to the ceiling mode or ceiling position. So I'll be cooking the biryani first on slow cook and high flame mode for 5 to 8 minutes. Then I'll be changing to slow cook and low flame for 15 to 20 minutes. So this Philips all-in-one electric cooker has these two modes. So slow cook high flame first for 5 to 8 minutes and then slow cook low flame for 15 to 20 minutes. If your electric cooker doesn't have these options, you can also cook the biryani by selecting pressure cook mode and cook it for 5 minutes and once done, let the pressure release naturally. If you're making the biryani using a normal pressure cooker, cook the biryani on low to medium flame for 10 minutes or until you get 2 whistles. So make sure it is on low to medium heat and the pressure has to release naturally. So once it is released, mix it gently without breaking the rice. So it's better to use a silicone spatula. You can try this one pot biryani recipe even with egg or chicken instead of prawns. Do try this recipe and let me know your feedback in the comment section below. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.